You probably already know that it pays well to be a software engineer. But if you look into the numbers on levels.fyi, you might start to notice that good compensation can become really, really good compensation as our career advances. And compensation is a reflection of the impact and business value one brings. So how do some of these engineers become so valuable? One word, career growth. Okay, that's two words. These people invested in their own career and focused on personal growth. This video will give you a good idea on how you can do that as well. I've seen people approaching their career developments in different ways. Some say that the easiest way is to keep jumping between different companies and getting a raise each time. And they are partially right. In some cases, that is the easiest way to give your compensation a quick bump. This is also a very personal choice, because sometimes the short-term compensation increase is indeed what's important to some people. However, that is not what I will recommend as the optimal approach if your goal is to grow towards L6 or higher. Because by focusing on interviews, you would be spending a lot of your time, which is your most valuable resource, on repetitive interview preparations instead of acquiring actual skills that can allow you to make more and more business impact. This is why I call it an investment, because instead of trying to squeeze value out of your early career, you can put efforts in that may not give you the quickest short-term compensation increase, but will allow you to create an exponential growth trajectory which can far surpass what you can get by simply jumping around. Before we talk about how to properly invest in your career, it's worth understanding the meaning of different levels and the key skills that's required. I covered this in a previous video, and you can find the link in the description down below. Long story short, different levels for software engineers represent very different expectations that require different sets of skills. You can basically think of them as different jobs. Advancing your career means acquiring skills required at higher levels. And that's where you should invest your time. Now let's walk through the concrete steps. There is a simple cycle that you will go through, which is to first prove your skills at one level and then start acquiring skills at the next level. Prove and grow. When you are a new entry-level engineer that just joined a company, you need to first prove that you can succeed as an L3 engineer comfortably. And through that process, you establish your credibility. So in this phase, when you think about what project to choose, try and identify something that matches L3 expectations, which is where you get well-defined tasks and make sure you have high confidence that you can execute them well. Ideally, you should work with your manager to align on measurable goals that indicate your success. For example, committing at least 3 code changes per week or finishing a set of tasks on time. This will allow you to prove that you do have L3 skills and are ready to move towards the next level. Once you achieve this, you should switch your focus onto acquiring L4 skills. This is when you should try to pick a project that pushes you out of your comfort zone and start to expose you to L4 expectations. Now, when you do that, you need to acknowledge that you are taking on a certain level of risk, because you are trying to do something you have never done before, and there's a chance you will fail a few times. But that's fine. And you should even expect it to happen. That's basically how you learn to walk, to talk, and to do everything else. The important thing here is to work closely with your manager throughout this process so that they have the right expectations and can provide you necessary support. Once you feel like you have all the skills required at L4, try and prove it. Pick a project that matches L4 expectations and use it to demonstrate the skills that you just acquired. When that's done, you should be getting your first promotion. And you can use that as an explicit signal to validate that you have indeed proven your L4 skills. Now repeat the cycle we talked about earlier. Prove and grow. The implication here is that immediately after your promotion, or even in the same meeting, where your manager told you about the promotion. You should ask how you can start growing towards L5 as soon as possible. Then the cycle repeats and you will be unstoppable. Sometimes you will realize that your team or even your company does not offer you the right opportunities where you can acquire the skills at the next level. In these cases, consider moving on. Seeking career growth is a much better reason to switch companies than looking for a compensation bump, because it gives you a very strong intentionality in where you go next. You should closely examine your options and make sure you are indeed getting the right kind of opportunities that can facilitate your growth. Once you arrive at L5 or above, you also start to see different potential paths ahead. For example, you can choose to be a people manager or keep going deeper as an individual contributor. And there are sub-branches within each of those two roles. I will have a future video that talks about the different paths in more depth. Please remember to subscribe if you don't want to miss it. See you next time.